Hey, Randy Joe here, and today we're going to continue things off on the channel with the January Blues series, a series where I'm going to listen to a blues album every weekday, Monday through Friday. And today we're going to kick off going into the British blues genre, a subgenre of the blues, with John Mayall and the Bluesbreakers' A Hard Road. Came out in 1968. I have reviewed John Mayall's and the Bluesbreakers' album, the Beano album, their breakthrough self-titled album with Eric Clapton. So I will not be listening to that one, unfortunately, but if you are interested in that, the link will be in the description and you can check out that review. But without further ado, we are going to jump into A Hard Road. It's only about 37 minutes or so. We're obviously not going to listen to the whole deluxe edition, but let's just kick it off. The first track here is A Hard Road. It is the title track. Let's just jump into it. Very high-pitched voice from Mayall. Very rough production. I think that might just be the 60s sound. Especially in that guitar, it's very sludgy. Looks like the vocalist might actually be Peter Green. Solid piano playing. I remember on the Beano album, I specifically liked the overall chemistry of all the band members. Much slower instrumental here. Really shows the talents of Mayall when he does the vocals, guitar, harmonica, piano, and the organ on this album. Really taking on every duty. Makes sense why he is the namesake of the band. I like that one. It was a solid opener. Good sense of rhythm in it. It's a slower one, but the rougher production kind of adds to the atmosphere, I think. Next we're going to It's Over. Much more soft regimen he's singing in. Really like that organ in the background too. Mayall on that organ. Really like the harmonica here and the drumming and really just every aspect of it really coming together strong in that segment. Like the way it brought it back down there. Alright. Solid track, nice rhythm. Not much to say about that one. Now we've got You Don't Love Me, the third track here. I think comes to British blues, there is a certain lack of warmth, in my experience at least, when it comes to British blues. There's a certain lack of warmth that comes with it. It's got a colder sound. Which, you know, whether or not you like that, it's really just a personal preference, I think. But, I guess less soul in it. Might be a hot take. Mayall's harmonica, you know, pretty sharp. Pretty solid harmonica player overall. I believe this is Peter Green on the vocals here. Not Mayall this time around. Solid guitar playing from, I believe it's Mayall and Peter Green. Not sure which is which here. Oh, I thought it was ending. It ramps right back up here. I love that finish. I thought that finish really brought that song home from a song that was overall somewhat lackluster, I would say, compared to the first couple of tracks. But nothing here quite blowing me away. Next we're going to The Stumble. I believe this seems like this is a Freddie King original. Really good guitar playing here. Just really showing off. Seems like this is a pure instrumental. And, you know, maybe that's a strength considering instrumentally, they're very rich and diverse in their playing. Might be one of the better tracks so far. Just some good old-fashioned blues. Drumming as well, coming in quite solid. Seems like it is... Who's the drummer on this bad boy here? Huey Flint or Ainsley Dunbar for drumming. Another Kind of Love is the name of this one. Really like that gentle organ playing in the back from Mayall. Really like the vocals on this one too. Much more hushed. Warmth. Bringing that warmth that I feel like a lot of these tracks lack. The drumming here too. I really like that rhythm. The ba-dum boom. It's nice and hard hitting. Those guitars are very electric, very heavy. Really like the brassy horns in the background, but I just wish they brought more to the forefront. Okay, closing that one out, we're going to slide right into the next one, Hit the Highway. That piano is just right in the forefront this time around. Got the vocals in both passages here. It's like self-harmonizing. Nice steady rhythm. Nothing jumping out me though. Nothing pronouncing itself quite strongly. I do like the vocals on this one. Much more distinct voice. I'm not sure if it's Green or Mayall here, but more nasally. Almost Kermit the Frog-ish. I like that one though. Strange as the vocals might be, I think it adds to the atmosphere. It's a little different. Next we're going right into Leaping Christine. Great opener. Swinging right in here. It's got a nice swing tone to it too. Got that old-fashioned swing blues sound. Much more upbeat than what we're used to here. Like the way he traded off his harmonica playing for his organ playing. Picture Mayall running across the stage to the next instrument. I'm liking this one. I love the more upbeat, skittery approach to it. A lot of short tracks on this album too, especially in the back half here. Oh, I got fooled. Blindsided. Next we're going to Dust My Blues. And boy, that is a screecher of a start. Back then, they didn't really mess around with electric guitars. You know, it was so exciting and new. I think they just screeched it right into your ear passages. It's got that more reverb-y, almost bar performance tone. I feel like I'm one with the audience. I'm not sure how I feel about this guitar. It's almost too loud for its own good. Maybe I've changed my mind. This passage here is definitely much better. Alright. I'm not sure how I feel about that one. You know, pretty decent instrumental overall, but I feel like there just wasn't a whole lot in terms of growth or a lot in terms of just, you know, differing itself from the rest. Next we've got There's Always Work, the lowest stream track here at 130,000. It's only a minute and a half. Maybe that's why. Maybe it serves more as an interlude. I like these much more eerie, washed out vocals up against this very clear harmonica. Two harmonicas, actually. I like this one, as weird as it is in terms of, you know, its length and how different it is. Very atmospheric. This would be a solid track and a movie as a transition. I can imagine a montage over it. Alright, closing it out. That's a brief little interlude, full of atmosphere, you know, not too dense. Next we're going into The Same Way, another short track. This is Peter Green, I believe, singing here. I like this instrumental, much slower, kind of sludgy. Best way to eat it. I like this one. I'm liking this one a lot. Typically like my blues, I think, a little bit slower, I've come to realize this month. I really like the instrumental up against the vocals. It's kind of got that call and response sort of formula. Tried and true blues formula that I really like with the instrumental here, kind of filling in that void. That was a solid track. I liked it. Much different than the rest so far. The Supernatural is the name of this one. I really like the percussion on this one too. It's got that supernatural tone, that's for sure. I think the atmosphere in general of this one seems a bit more heightened in a supernatural sense. Guitar really wrapping around there. Wrapping around my mind, I should say. I think I'm liking the second half of this album more than the first half. I'm loving this track, actually. This is beautiful. Supernatural is right. It's very eerie atmosphere. got a nice palpable tone.
Solid track. Solid, great atmosphere, great instrumental. Think that might be the best track here. Makes sense, it has the most streams. Next we're on to Top of the Hill. I like Mayall's distinct voice. It was a solid performance as well. But again, overall, I don't think, it's hard not to compare it to their breakout debut album, the Beano album. But it's not, I don't think this one is as breakthrough-ish in a way as that one. But I do like a lot of the tracks here. And the guitar work is just as strong, despite not being Clapton, who I think is kind of overrated, to be honest. Nice rhythm on this one, though, overall. I really like the horns on this. Big horn fan, if you haven't caught on yet. This has a nice, more soulful approach. I really love his vocals here. He's just singing his soul out. Maybe his best performance on here. One of his best performances as a vocalist. Solid melody and rhythm on that one. On to the last track, we've got Living Alone. Oh. The production on this one is... What is going on here? Very, mutilated here, the production. Borderline experimental. What is going on here? The playing on this one is just tortured sounding. This is how they want to end it? I love how grotesque this one sounds. It's really weird. I'm not really sure what to make of the very weird instrumental, though. Okay. Very strange outro track. Odd one to leave things off of. Very just poorly produced, maybe? Intentionally produced that way? I can't imagine. It's not intentional, considering the rest of the album does not sound like that. But it's very, very strange, I would say, given how, I would say, expected a lot of this album was after you get used to its overall style. But that final track really just, it's not anything else on this album. But all in all, that pretty much does it for the listening of A Hard Road. Pretty solid album throughout. I do find some of it is a little bit weaker than the rest. But certain tracks, especially in the second half, I feel like pull things away from the expected trajectory of this album. And Mayall as a singer, I think, is also pretty fantastic throughout this thing. Peter Green does cover a couple tracks, but I think it's Mayall's voice that really stands out as a more unique one. But again, if I'm going to compare this to the Beano album, I would have to say that I do like the Beano album, I think, still more. I remember it stood out a lot more to me at the time when I listened to it, but this is still quite a solid LP. But that pretty much does it for A Hard Road from John Mayall and the Bluesbreakers. All in all, I said what I said. I think it is fairly decent. Not my favorite I've heard this month, but certainly a interesting and worthwhile listen, especially in the British blues subgenre. But if you are a blues fan, then please go ahead and leave a comment down below recommending a blues album, whether it be a classic or a diamond in the rough, etc., etc. I would love to check it out for the month of January while we cover blues albums. And if you like this video, please hit like and subscribe to follow along and not only listen to blues albums, but new albums and albums that will go along with other forthcoming months and their specific genres that I will tie to them. But as always, my name is Randy Joe, and I'm signing off.